Hello everyone, so today I am doing a video about factional warfare in EVE Online. Now, I just joined factional warfare a bit ago. I've been in it some, but not much. It's pretty fun. I enjoy it more than what I was in. I used to be in Brave Newbies, even though I've been playing the game for a very long time. Many years, or like 4 years, I think. I don't know. I need to set this to 200,000. Aw, they left. Oh well, guess this is mine now. Anyways, faction warfare, what you do is you find sites, you warp to them, you orbit them, and you kill anyone who fights you. We have a social one here. So you'll notice how I have the D-scan open. It's the number one thing for factional warfare. Honestly, anyone who is interested in EVE, I would recommend this. Depending on what you want to play EVE for. Honestly, NullSec has kind of just become a big fuckfest of drama. So I left. Wasn't too fun anymore because it was just form up for no reason at all. And all of this stuff. Wait a minute, what the hell? Oh, he died. I thought I had Rex on one of these. Huh, oh well, fuck it. So this is what happens is orbit these outposts, and as you orbit them, the timer goes down. When the timer goes up, you get loyalty points. Lots of loyalty points. They build up. You go to a station that's friendly. Wrong key button thing. Journal. I'm checking my D-scan very often to make sure I don't get surprise attacked. Notice how many I have. And that's honestly not for much. So yeah, this is basically all that you do in factional warfare. When it's quiet. When it's not quiet, you actively kill things. I haven't had much luck with fighting yet because I've noticed the Kaldari Militia doesn't seem too organized compared to the Galente Militia. So I keep getting into 1v1 fights and then getting ganked by fleets from the Galente side. So that's the next thing I will suggest. You should join a corporation. And in fact, I'm going to advertise my corporation. Kill them with kindness. Apparently I've been a member for a month. That's cool. You should apply to join this corporation. Why? Because when we grow, we can do fun shit. That's how it is with anything in EVE. The more people, the more fun. Usually. At least. This is really the first quality EVE video I'm uploading. You can call this quality even. You'll notice this bar right here. The higher contested this gets, the more valuable it'll become, so it'll pay out more. Also, if I would have killed that guy, I would have gotten a reward for it, because you actually get rewarded in loyalty points for killing enemies. Oh, enemies of the other militia. If this person comes in and they're in a bigger ship, I'm just gonna run because I won't get a loyalty point payout. It's not worth dying for. So another thing is people will always try to guilt trip you, not guilt trip you, but call you a shitter and everything if you leave a fight. If you are trying to save money or not die all the time, don't feel bad about leaving a fight that you could obviously tell you're outgunned from. That's why I have this open. If I see something come up here that I know could kill my retribution, Is that what this is? Yep. I can still remember that. I'll just warp out. And they'll probably call me a shitter in local, but that's okay, because I can fight them with something else. What the hell is flashing red? I could have sworn I saw something flashing red underneath the little symbol I have that I'm recording right now. So this site is going to take a while. I'm not feeling it, so I'm going to go warp around and see if I can find shit to kill. See. This will give me all the stats that I haven't done much of. Another thing I like about this is there's no one telling me I have to be on all the time. There's not the stress, because I do a lot of other things. I have a job, I have hobbies, lots of outdoor hobbies, and I enjoy other video games. I've already sunk 2,000 some hours into Eve. I don't need to play it for 5 hours every day anymore. I mean, of course, I'll play it as long as it's fun, but I'm enjoying new games as well. Ooh, okay, so there's some newts in this system. They're probably in a fleet. Definitely in a fleet. Those aren't newts, though. Those are war targets. And then newts as well. I've noticed the newts in factional warfare will attack a lot. Pirates, usually. So far, I've died more times in factional warfare, oh shit, than I have ever in NullSec. And I've been in this a lot less. I was living in NullSec for about a year and a half. And I died like maybe 5 times. And with this, I've died a good 12 to 15 times in the last month. And it's been really fun, because they're good fights. It's not just gigantic blobs of shit. It's not as stressful. Makes Eve more fun. Ooh. Somebody died here. That means there's a pirate in local. Okay, so there was a Galente ship running the site before one of them killed them. Glad to see Kaldari was capturing, though. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is try and run this site while watching DC. Anyone who wants to play Eve, number one thing I can recommend, if you have a question, Google it, because other people have probably had that question. There's a lot of complex shit in this game. And it only recently has been made somewhat bearable. Oh shit. Someone from my corporation got killed in this site. That's interesting. I barely even see anyone from my corporation. Cool. All in all, faction warfare is pretty easy. It is a solid source of income, though. Honestly, what I'm probably going to do is make my main income from this, and make an alt to do other fun things with. Better just use this account for PvP all the time, since I have so many combat skills. It's a good source of income that's also not mind-numbingly grinding boring. Most of the time. Okay, sometimes it is. Like right now, I just have to wait for that timer to go down. Which is boring as hell. feel like I'm gonna fall asleep just waiting for it to stop. Oh, more newts. Yay. I've had it happen before where I'm just sitting there and I, like, wait a few seconds more than usual to click and can't get out in time and they're in something like a fucking Garmer. That's one of the things I've noticed other people will invest lots of money into a frigate for this when this is the most expensive ship I've used so far for it, because I usually plan to die with that ship, so I consider it an investment, and that ship has to earn its money back. And with cheap ships, that's really easy. I could run one site with, I don't even remember the name of the ship I used. Tristan, that's it. Can run one site with a Tristan, and it's paid for. This ship, I have to run multiple sites with. As the more expensive it gets, the more you have to worry about not dying. Hell, if they came in here right now and killed me, that'd be okay. And then, of course, the rats spawn every few minutes. Small sites get a destroyer, novice sites get a frigate. Novice sites, you can only use T1 and faction frigates. Small sites, you can only use destroyers, T2 frigates, and below. Medium sites, I believe you can use Tech-1 cruisers, and large sites, Tech-2 cruisers. There's a chart online that shows all of it. EVE Online is full of... well, the internet, at least, is full of charts about EVE Online and spreadsheets and all that fun stuff. If one of them comes in here, even if it's a fight I know I'm gonna lose, I'm going to engage. It's just because of boredom. How much ISK do I have? Not much. As always. If you have too much ISK, then you're not having enough fun. Remember that. So they just updated FozzySolve in EVE. I'm not sure what all the changes are because I've stopped giving as much of a shit about that and paid more attention to update news of upcoming things like Fallout 4, and which I'll be doing a playthrough of, and No Man's Sky. I am excited for No Man's Sky. Procedurally generated, landing on worlds, all that shit seems hella fun. Kind of like Elite Dangerous if it was more. Just more in general. Of course, there's a lot more simulation stuff to that. EVE Online could have something like that. That wouldn't be too hard to implement if the code wasn't, you know, 12, 13 years old. Got 5 minutes left on this side. Shit's boring as hell. But that's alright. This is called farming, basically. Actually, yeah, this is farming. Waiting for a fight. Or avoiding a fight. People will hate you for farming. You'll make more money that way, though. If you're only worried about ISK, farming is the best way to do it. If you go and try to fight everything, you're gonna have a bad time. Because you're going to die a lot. And you're gonna end up as negative in the long run. Honestly, if you're just getting into faction warfare, I would suggest start with farming, take the ship, or fly with a group, because then you'll win most fights. then after you have the money, start fighting, because you want to make sure you have the money to fight, and you don't end up fucking yourself over. Alright, so there's a minute and a half left on this. After I've been sitting here for a good 9 minutes, not been attacked yet. I'm not gonna stop checking D-Scan though, because I've had them show up in the last 5 seconds before, and that is really a buzzkill. Die 5 seconds away from getting a good payout. It does happen though, so you have to make sure that you check D-Scan. This is basically just my thoughts on how I do faction warfare. This is what I was talking about. I've been killed by them before, I think. Okay, so they have a minute and a half to get here. And then they might... God damn it. This is what I hate about the Galente. There's always more than one of them. There's always a fucking fleet of them. Okay, let's pick a planet to align to. We'll pick planet one. Come on, just stay away for one more minute, please. Fuck. Okay, so they all came into local at about the same time, so I can tell they're in a fleet. So if I see any of them show up on D-Scan, I'm going to warp off, because that's unfightable for me. Heart's going. I just want them to stay away for a few more seconds. Contested. Nope. Local's dropping. No, it's not. 20 seconds. Come on. Did they decide I'm not worth it? What they might do is just leave one person, and he'll warp to the site, and I'll engage them, and when I'm scrambled, then the rest will warp in. But it would appear that they decided they have bigger fish to fry, so I'm gonna get the payout for this site. Boom, I got the loyalty points. I'm gonna get the fuck out while I can, because they could still come for me. So I got paid 17,500 loyalty points. Now, what to do with those loyalty points? Well, with one site, you're not going to have enough for anything, so I'm going to go back to my corporation's home system, which I think is kind of an alliance, or not alliance, but militia home system. Don't quote me on that, though. I could be quite wrong. Also, don't forget, there are three other militias besides the one I'm in. Two besides the one that we've seen, because there's also the Amar and Minmatar, if people still play them. I don't know. Kaldari and Galente are the biggest ones, obviously, because they're the ones that get the most attention in the game. Though the Amar Empress just died, some lore stuff that happened today when this video was made. Actually, I guess 3 hours ago, because I'm in a different time zone than Eve. Oh, shit. I had a feeling some shit like this was gonna happen. Are they gonna get me? No, they're not! Not today, bitch! Haha. But yeah. There's some lore. I feel like I like Faction Warfare more because there's a lot more lore involved. Backstory to the game, which is stuff that I like. I could kill both of them. But not their friends, because they have lots of friends. The system I'm about to go through is a home system to an enemy corporation, so there's a good chance that there'll be lots of them waiting for me on a gate. It's really scary to jump into a system and see this many flashing orange boxes. And of course, ask if you join the militia, ask questions in the militia chat. People will help you. Sometimes. A lot of times they don't feel like it. You can see how close this system's getting. Ooh. I might come back here and help them fight. Because we can flip this system soon. When this reaches a high point, the system will, the iHub actually in the system will become vulnerable, and then both sides will try to switch it. And the winner gets the system. Then it all happens again, because that's how EVE Online works.
Fuck, I'm not gonna talk anyway, I'm tired.
I've honestly made the mistake of making lots of videos when I'm tired. I didn't even mean to say that. But I guess that applies too. But playing EVE when I'm tired. So I end up doing lots of stupid shit sometimes. Because this is a game that you really shouldn't be tired when you play. But usually when I'm awake, I use it for advantage in a game like Counter-Strike or PlanetSide, because first-person shooter reaction time is good. Okay, so HiSec, where I'm about to be, is not safe when you're in the militia, because the enemy militia will still attack you. Okay, that might be the home system for the militia, I don't know. OPSEC, spy, I know that someone, if this they see the video, is gonna say, "Oh my god, why did you cover up the chat?" Because that's that stuff. But there is so many fucking spies in here. Because it's open, and that's a real easy way to get kills, is just look at the intel that gets reported. That's why it's good to be in a corporation that's good size, so you can form fleets and not talk in militia chat. That's how you die. One thing I really like about EVE that's just happened in the past couple years is how beautiful it has become. With the new graphic updates and everything. And the size of the station. Docking permission requested. That wasn't changed, it's just something that looks awesome to me. The scale of everything. Dock at the station with your wonderful loyalty points. You'll go to the loyalty point store. And honestly, I think the most profitable one is one of these. What I usually do is get one of these, build it since I have good industry skills, and sell it. And you make a good profit because of how expensive those ships are. You can do it with anything though, anything you want. There's good tools online to look up how much you'll make off that, how much you'll have to spend and to build it. So yeah. That is how you make money with faction warfare, kind of. I'm too tired to provide good commentary, but that was how you do faction warfare and what I think of it. I like it. It's casual. I like casual. And it's still fun. Thank you for watching. Please check out EVE. I'm going to put a link in the description where you can check out a 21-day, or it might have changed to 30-day free trial of EVE. And you could do that free trial. I'll get free stuff for it if you subscribe. Check out the free trial, see if you like the game. If you like it, you can subscribe and then join Faction Warfare. Come join our corporation. We would love to have you. And we'll teach you how to do things properly. We'll form fleets and everything when we get more people. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.